In this screencast, we're going to discuss how to calculate vapor-liquid equilibrium for a multi-component system by using equation state. In this case, the equation state will account for both the non-ideal vapor phase and the non-ideal liquid phase. The particular example we'll look at is the bubble point pressure calculation. Namely, for given the mole fractions in the liquid phase, Xi, and we're given the temperature of the system, we want to determine the mole fractions in the vapor phase, Yi, and the pressure of the system. And we'll do this with an iterative approach. So in this screencast, we'll explain the procedure and the actual calculations. We'll use a spreadsheet that has an equation state built into it to demonstrate with numerical values in a separate screen test. So to calculate this equilibrium, what we're doing is setting the fugacity of each component in the liquid phase equal to the fugacity of each component in the vapor phase. And then we can write this fugacity in the liquid phase as the mole fraction in the liquid phase, the fugacity coefficient in the mixture, and that symbol indicates in the mixture, for the liquid times the pressure. And then the fugacity in the vapor phase looks very similar, but it's mole fraction now in the vapor phase, the fugacity coefficient in the vapor phase times the pressure. So the pressure drops out, and we're going to use this equation where we'll write Y over Xi equals Ki. The idea now, we can calculate Ki from the fugacity coefficients, and Ki is the fugacity coefficient in the liquid phase over the fugacity coefficient in the vapor phase, and this is for each component. So our approach, in order to calculate the fugacity coefficients, we need the pressure, which we don't know, since the pressure affects the fugacity coefficients. And to calculate the vapor phase values, we also need the mole fractions in the vapor phase, which is also something we don't know and we're trying to solve for. So what we're going to do is we're going to guess a pressure and guess each of the mole fractions. We can certainly make intelligent guesses for the mole fractions, for example, if we have information, so we could use Raoult's law as a first approximation. We could certainly do that. But we're going to make that guess. We're then going to calculate these fugacity coefficients, so both the vapor phase and the liquid phase values. The next step is to calculate each of the Ki values. Once we have Ki, we can calculate a new value for the mole fraction in the vapor phase. And so what we're going to do is say Yi, new values for Yi, Ki, Xi. This is known. This we calculate it from the fugacity coefficients. This now should be a better than our original guess value. So a couple approaches we could use. If the sum of Yi equals 1, it means we actually guessed the completely correct values. That's, of course, not very likely. And so most likely, either less than 1 or greater than 1. So let's say the sum is less than 1. That means we want to make a new guess of a lower value for the pressure. If it was greater than 1, we'd want to make a new guess of a higher value for the pressure. Of course, when we change the pressure, we're going to get new values for the fugacity coefficients. Of course, that means new values for the Ki, and therefore we'll get new values for Yi. We can get better values for the fugacity coefficients by normalizing the Yi. Namely, take our Yi values, divide it by the sum, in order to normalize so the sum is equal to 1, use those Yi values to calculate our to gas the coefficients in the vapor phase. And now we have an iterative procedure. You get new fugacity coefficients. If they don't sum to 1, when we calculate the new yi values, then we go back and adjust pressures, and we'll continue that loop until the sum of the yi equals 1. And then we would have determined the pressure and the yi values in vapor-liquid equilibrium. Of course, with a spreadsheet, this iterative approach is easier to do and probably easier to visualize. So in a subsequent screencast, we'll go through the actual numbers using this procedure. Of course, instead of bubble pressure, if we wanted bubble temperature, essentially the same calculation, but we're going to guess temperature because the pressure is given, and we're going to guess, again, the mole fractions in vapor phase.